Look, he's a high-quality person, Mike. He's a very high-quality, he's a very brilliant guy. And now I have you telling me about dog walking, washing dishes. And you know what? I'd rather have him on the phone with some world leader than have him wash dishes because maybe his wife isn't there or his kids are there. You know, what are you telling me? It's terrible. It's so stupid. You know how stupid that sounds to the world? Unbelievable. Okay, yeah.
Explain, sir, why you decided to fire the Inspector General at the State Department.
Yeah, I don't know him at all. I never even heard of him. But I was asked to by the State Department, by Mike. I offered most of my people, almost all of them. I said, you know, these are Obama appointees, and if you'd like to let him go, I think you should let him go, but that's up to you. He's an Obama employee. I understand he had a lot of problems with the DOD. There was an investigation on him, on the Inspector General. I don't know anything about it. So I don't know him, never heard of him, but they asked me to terminate him. I have the absolute right as president to terminate. I said, who appointed him? And they said, President Obama. I said, look, I'll terminate him. I don't know what's going on other than that, but you'd have to ask Mike Pompeo. But they did ask me to do it, and I did it. I have the right to terminate the inspector generals. I would have suggested, and I did suggest in pretty much all cases, you get rid of the attorney generals because it happens to be very political, whether you like it or not. And many of these people were Obama appointments. And so I just got rid of them.
And you've got some criticism from Democrats in Congress who are saying this is a pattern of you trying to avoid having accountability.
Yeah, I know. And if I didn't fire them, they would have criticized me, too. They'd criticize no matter what you do. You know, if you have too many ventilators, they'll say, gee, he has too many ventilators. If you don't have enough, they'll say he doesn't have enough. No matter what you do, between that and their partner, the fake news media, they'll find something. No, I don't know the gentleman. I was happy to do it. Mike requested that I do it. He should have done it a long time ago, in my opinion. He's an Obama appointment, and he had some difficulty. But I just don't know who he is. I don't know. I never heard his name.
Do you believe there is a role for inspector generals to keep an administration like yours or anyone else as accountable?
Sure, but I think they have to be fair. And I think it's a death wish when you and I told my people, I said, I think you should study your situation, but let us know. I think we've been treated very unfairly by inspector generals. I can go into instances, but I'm not going to do it now. But the inspector generals, when they're put in by Obama, just like it could be that if they were put in by me and it was somebody else's administration, especially the other party, it could very well be that you'd be treated unfairly. But we've had a lot of cases where we thought that was unfair. They asked me to do that. I think the big thing is that they should have asked me to do it a long time ago.
You said you don't know him, sir. What was he doing that was treating you unfairly?
I don't know. I don't know anything about him. I don't know. I don't know anything about him other than the State Department and Mike in particular. I guess they weren't happy with the job he's doing or something. So because it's my right to do it, I said, sure, I'll do it. I've gotten rid of a lot of inspector generals. Every president has. I think every president has gotten rid of probably more than I have. A lot of our people kept the Obama inspector general. And I think generally speaking, that's not a good thing to do, but they've kept him. But I told them for 3 years, I said, anybody wants to get rid of their inspector generals because they were appointed by President Obama, I think you should do so. Some of them didn't, but now they're doing, a couple of them are doing it now. Yeah, go ahead.
Mr. President, isn't there at least an appearance of a conflict of interest if Secretary Pompeo is asking you to fire an inspector general?
That I can't tell you. I don't think so. I think maybe he thinks he's being treated unfairly. Again, he wanted to, he asked me if that would be possible. I said, I'll do that, sure. I think it should have been done a long time ago, frankly. And this is a man that has had some controversy, this inspector general. But so, again, I don't know anything. I haven't even read much about him. I see that it's a little bit of a story, not much of a story, because everybody agrees that I have the absolute right to fire the inspector generals. I think they should have done it a long time ago. Yes, please.